Hi, I'm Brett Parker, multimedia specialist for snack food and wholesale bakery. And today we're talking with Joe Lewis, CEO of Famous Brands International, as he shares insights into how a food company tracks data and cultivates ideas for desserts and baked goods. Joe, thank you so much for joining us today.
Thank you very much, Brett. Glad to be here, and thank you for having me.
What methods do you employ to find the best consumer trends in terms of desserts and baked goods?
You know, we have and I think it's one thing to point out, we've got a process, and I've developed that over the years, of how we evaluate trends, new products, things of that nature, you know. And one of the, I think, the key factors to kind of step back in, you know, before you start evaluating products is what type of concept you have, and what, you know, that how that product will fit into your existing brand and your strategy, and how's it going to impact that strategy. So what we do is obviously look for trends in the marketplace. We look at market research. We look at, you know, competitors. We look at what's selling out there in the marketplace now, maybe in some other types of concepts that we can maybe track that are similar to ours. And then we also, you know, look, take input from our franchisees on what customers are asking for, what they're, you know, what they see in their marketplace too. One of the advantages that we have as a franchisor, we are a franchisor of the Mrs. Fields cookies brand and the TCBY frozen yogurt brand. And one of the advantages we have as a franchisor, and other franchisors have, is you have a franchise owner, an owner operator usually, that's in the market, that's talking with the customers every day and finding out, you know, what they're asking for or what the trends are in their local market, which gives us a lot of feedback from those owners too in that space.
So if there was a specific menu, let's say, that needed more innovation, would you rely more heavily on consumer trends, or would you trust more the intuition of your employees and bakers?
Good question. I would take that combination, both of that combination. I think it's important to have the objective data to evaluate, because you'll get a lot of emotion sometimes in with, you know, certain individuals that, although they may love a certain product, but then it may not be something that, you know, will move in the marketplace or will sell. So we like to, you know, you always want to utilize both of those options, because that it gives you a good check and a good, when you have the individuals, we do try and test whatever products that we bring in. We try and test those products with our franchise owners in, you know, certain markets that are representative of, you know, the demographic that we serve.
In your experience, do you find consumers want more innovation with their baked goods and desserts, or are they more nostalgic for classical flavors from the past?
Yeah, that's another good question. And one of the trends in kind of preparing for this this discussion with you is just really evaluating trends with our vendors too. You know, that's another very good place to start, you know, with innovation and trends, because they're seeing what's selling from their standpoint, you know, from the vendor standpoint. And, you know, with what we're seeing right now, which is great for our brands, because we're pioneers in our industry, we're, you know, over 40 years old in both brands, and we've got two really iconic brands with a lot of heritage. So that nostalgia is important. And we're seeing that in our brands too, that with the economy, with, you know, people are struggling now with a lot of the inflation and the higher costs, even though we're seeing some progress in that area. But over the last few years, even with higher wages, people have been struggling. So I think they're going back to a time, and I've seen that this in several publications and from talking with our vendors, that nostalgia is the winner this time. You know, you've got gluten-free products and vegan products that are, you know, are definitely moving, but the nostalgia is really where people want to kind of step back to a time when they were happier and I guess not struggling as much, or at least they thought they were at that point. So we do see that. That nostalgia is really I think, the overriding theme right now.
Can you recall any specific consumer or nutrition trends that have historically had the biggest impact on like franchise expansion plans or restaurant concepts consistently?
I think the trend overall has been health and nutrition. I come from a background, with Smoothie King franchises, and started with Smoothie King in the early days. When we had 39 stores, and now Smoothie King's over 1,000 stores. And I think one of the drivers of that growth was that people wanted a more healthier lifestyle. And we see that with TCBY more than Mrs. Fields, but in TCBY, people now are looking more for products that will fit in with their dietary needs, right? And the and we see I've seen that trend go. You've got the development of Panera off of that trend. You can look at multiple other brands that have really grown from that overall health and nutrition trend, and better ingredients, more wholesome ingredients, better, moving more towards, natural ingredients that aren't artificial. I think that has been the biggest driver of the trend overall that I've seen. And I think that's going to continue. Although what we're seeing with Mrs. Fields is interesting. Is we have tried those products in the past. We've tried gluten-free, we've tried vegan, we've tried fat-free. And when it comes to certain brands, people want, to indulge. When they go out and want to spend money on a treat, for example, like a Mrs. Fields, maybe versus a TCBY or another more healthier product, they really want that to indulge in that treat and enjoy the product. And so we've seen people stay with our core products rather than go to a more dietary specific product with Mrs. Fields. Now, TCBY, we have a good following in consumers who are guests who do want to come in and meet some of their dietary needs with that product.
So if there was a bakery or dessert space that wanted to upscale and expand more, but didn't know where to begin, what advice would you give to them?
I think it's like anything. You've got to really develop the niche that you're going to serve in that space. And especially in our space, in a more the bakery standpoint, you've got to really figure out how you're going to compete with these other more upscale bakeries that are serving a more luxurious, product. Mrs. Fields, we consider ourselves a high value, a premium high value product. But not in that luxury space. So I think, they would have to, my recommendations would be to really define that niche. And if you're the competitors in that niche, plus how you're going to price that product and how you're going to the ingredients from a health standpoint of, you're going to have premium ingredients, but how you're going to, establish your brand and your brand strategy and service that niche and carve out. Why would that customer base come to you? You're still going to have to figure that out. Just go back to the basics and fundamentals. And then if you do have a good product, an excellent product, and you can differentiate yourself from some of those others in that niche, then I think you've got a pretty good start.
Great. Well, that's all the time that we have for today. Joe Lewis of Famous Brands International, thank you so much for your time. We really appreciate it.
Brett, thank you for having me. I really appreciate it also.
And thank you all for watching.